Hey there, everybody. In this video, we're going to talk about how to use digital marketing to grow your business. If you've ever said to yourself, I need to start doing something to get more clients and more customers, then this is a great video for you. We're going to talk about how to set up what are called sales funnels, why they're so important, and how you can use them to create growth in your business. How's it going, everybody? My name is Brandon Brashears, and this is the Digital Marketing Madman channel. I want to say thanks for watching this video. If you enjoy it, please consider subscribing and give a thumbs up here. I do daily marketing videos, and I cover everything from principles to doing tutorial walkthroughs, and just I create videos every single day. So if you need any help, please be sure to comment below. If you have any topics or ideas or need help with anything, please just comment below. I'm happy to help. All right, so let's get into today's video. So digital marketing is one of the best ways to reach your clients and customers. And the reason for that is people are spending more and more time online. If you look at numbers on people watching TV and other traditional mediums of advertising, it's just going down further and further. And so if you're not on digital marketing, you should be getting on as soon as possible. The best time to start was like 10 years ago. And if you're not able to do that, which nobody is, today is the best day to get started. So don't put it off any further. So first of all, what is digital marketing? I actually created a video talking about what digital marketing is. So if you want to know more about what digital marketing is, you can check that video out by clicking on that card. But one of the biggest and most important aspects of digital marketing are sales funnels. And funnels are basically where we take people from evaluation or from awareness. We need people to first be aware of us, then they can evaluate us, and then they can convert and become customers. If somebody does not know about your business, there's no way that they're going to actually be able to do business with you. So they have to become aware somehow. Once they're aware, they have to say, is this a good business? Is it legit? What do their reviews look like? Is this something that is actually going to work for my problem? And then if that is the case, they will buy. So that's an oversimplification of digital marketing and sales funnels, but you get the picture. If you want more help about what sales funnels are, I created additional videos talking about what they are. You can click on this card right up here. But the reason why sales funnels are so important is that if you have a business and you're probably the best employee that you have in your business, wouldn't it be great if you could duplicate yourself so that you didn't have to continue to work harder and work more to create growth in your business, right? So digital marketing allows you to do that, and it's done through sales funnels. Now, sales funnels, again, are driving people from awareness to evaluation and then to conversion. So if you have a predictable selling system that lets you attract new customers, allows you to engage people that are in evaluation and then convert and then reconvert, that's going to create growth for your business. So you need to be creating sales funnels for your business and using the tools and tactics that you need to based on where your customers are, depending on their demographics and things like that. So if you're not sure who your customers are, that's the very first step that you need to do. Once you understand what that first step is and who they are, what is the end goal that you have in mind with them? Because you want to start with the end in mind is, what is the end objective that we're looking to achieve here? If you're a carpet cleaning business, then having somebody become a client and get their carpets cleaned and then create referrals and have you come back often, that's going to be the goal. If you are a dentist, having new clients come in for braces or getting root canals or whatever it is that you do. So depending on what your business is, you're going to have an end goal in mind. And so we start there and then we reverse engineer it. Again, we talk about all of the funnel stuff. If you click up here in the corner, I have a video that explains funnels and also top of funnel, middle of funnel, and bottom of funnel in depth so that you can get more. But I just want to instill that sales funnels are extremely important. And the reason for that is that you're able to create systems that are predictable. And it doesn't require you to do more work. If you're really good at your business, and most owners of the business are the best employee in the company, and a lot of times they act like employees because they don't have things set up. So if you are looking to grow your business, but you don't necessarily want to hire more people because it's expensive. I live in California, and if you hire a full-time employee, it costs $40,000 per employee. So you can use sales funnels to basically automate a lot of the processes that you have with bringing on new clients. So creating content is part of the awareness phase. If you can create content, it allows people to get to know you at scale. It allows you to engage with customers at scale and basically duplicates yourself. And then if you have middle of funnel content, which typically are things like guides and tools and resources and cheat sheets and additional videos and content. If you have that working and being sent out automatically, you're able to then duplicate the evaluation phase where you would typically have to get on the phone and talk with a customer or potential client. So if you can take away some of that workload from the middle of the funnel, that also helps. And then being able to drive people to the bottom of the funnel where they're going to make a purchase decision or rebuy automatically, placing orders, doing things like that, you're able to generate a lot more sales without you having to physically be there to take them. Now, I'm not saying that this is going to replace everything. If you're able to increase the number of leads that you have coming in, hopefully you're going to be able to just spend more time closing and following up. I think that digital marketing doesn't replace being, number one, a good business owner, providing an amazing service, and helping your clients and customers get the end goal that they want to get. So I just wanted to mention that for a second here. Digital marketing doesn't take away the human aspect. It just helps to create scale for your business. So if you want to use digital marketing to grow your business, I think that the first place that you're going to want to start is, number one, with the client avatar and figuring out exactly who your client is. Now, I'm going to create a video here about how to create an in-depth client avatar. Right now, I have three questions you should ask before you run any ads, which talks about your business and your service and how to frame it in a way that matters to your potential customers. And I think that that's really important. So finding out first who you are going to be serving with your product and service. Next, we're going to figure out the end goal that we have in mind. We're then going to figure out something that's going to be useful or helpful that you can offer those people in terms of an offer so that you can get their contact information and then hopefully drive them to the bottom of the funnel. And then at the top of the funnel, we're going to figure out what kind of content is going to help engage with these people so that they're going to segment themselves and identify themselves as somebody who's going to be a potential client. So that's really, in general, how you use digital marketing to grow your business. I will say that if you're thinking about starting with digital marketing, starting out by figuring out what your bottom of funnel offer is and then working to optimize that is going to help you generate a lot more ROI than if you started at the top and you just started creating content. A lot of times people will say, hey, digital marketing doesn't work for me. I've tried it. You know, Facebook doesn't work. Instagram doesn't work. I'm just not getting anywhere. And the reason for that is they're creating tons of content, but they're not actually showing offers to their audience. And so if you're just constantly showing them, you know, cute cat pictures and they're engaging, but ultimately they're not coming into your business, you're going to say, hey, this isn't working. I'm working really hard at it and it's just not working. You need to have the end in mind and figure out the exact path and the journey that you're going to take them to get from the before to the after. And if you can do that and express that in terms of, here's exactly how I'm going to help you, here's what you're going to get, here's what it's going to look like at the end. If you can do that, then you're going to attract clients and customers. And really, digital marketing is just like any other marketing medium. It's also like any other human interaction that you're having. The way that you reach people and the scale is different, but it's really been designed to let people keep in touch with each other. It's been designed to help people to communicate. And if you think about digital marketing in general, everything from email to social media, it was initially designed so that you could connect with your friends and be personal and share more and be authentic. It's changed a lot since then, but I think that you can understand that if you start to use it like it was meant to be used, and also if you start to use these channels like people are using them currently, instead of constantly broadcasting, like you're shouting into a megaphone, you're engaging with people, you're building actual relationships, you're going to go a lot further and you're going to see a lot better results. So remember, on the other side of that screen is an actual person, and think about how you would want to be treated as a customer or a prospective customer and treat other people that way. So driving people down your funnel is going to help to create scalable growth. It's going to help you relieve some of the back-end work that you have to do to drive people from being strangers into customers. If you need any help with this, please comment below. I'm happy to help, happy to give you ideas. And I love making these digital marketing videos. I love talking with other small business owners who want to increase their business with digital marketing. So I'm always happy to help. Be sure to comment if you liked the video and consider subscribing. So have a great day, and I'll